No producer knows everything. You're never going to know everything. And that's okay. After Searching had come out, we made that film for very little money. We sold it at Sundance and it had a really great release and grossed $75 million at the box office. So that really kind of put us on the map in the sense of we were now filmmakers. Aneesh, our director, was now a director who is bankable, right? Like he can bring a return for the studio, for the investor. And so we kind of knew when we went to Sundance that, you know, best case scenario, we're going to sell the film and that there will be a little bit of heat on us. So going into Sundance, Aneesh and Sev already had about half of the script of Run already, because we knew everyone was going to ask us at Sundance the question that you're always asked as a filmmaker, what's next? And we wanted to be able to at least like softly pitch it and get some interest from people so that when the script was ready, we could go to them and there was already some like buzz drummed up. A lot of people ask this, you know, should I send my work in progress cut or should I wait till next year and send the finished cut? There's no official rule. They watch work in progress cuts. I think these programmers are used to seeing things that aren't finished. But I will say, if you just take a step back and think about it, like if you have something that's unfinished, you're going to be competing against a lot of films that submit fully finished. So if you have the ability to wait, I'm of the mindset, I feel this way about sending scripts out as well. Like, put your best foot forward, right? Like wait, make the thing as good as it can possibly be, because you only get one objective watch or read of anything. And really you want to be as good as you can. Most films I've done have been smaller things and they're low budget. And by nature of that, we can't hire veterans, right? Like we're always looking to work with people who are entering their career, starting their career. And that was out of necessity. But what I've learned out of doing that is when you hire people that just want to be there and have the passion, but haven't had the chance yet, you can be blown away and you'll really never know, you know, what talent is untapped if you don't tap into it. There's a lot of barriers to entry in this business that are totally arbitrary. So take a chance on people. And I feel as a producer, I have a responsibility to take a chance on people. You know, the fun part of this job is there's always a solution, right? The kind of key to making those is oftentimes not having too many locations and too many speaking roles, because literally those directly correlate to the budget going up. Because every time you move locations, it's increased costs and less shooting time. Like look at, okay, what are key scenes where we want to splurge on background? And I would say you want to space those scenes out, right? Like you don't want to put all the like expensive scenes in one act of the film. You want to kind of spread them out. Same thing with locations. Like if you're going to be contained for all of act one, try to widen out as the movie goes on. Definitely have a side hustle. If it can be something that's in the industry where you're flexing your filmmaking brain, all the better. So for me, it was because I came up under a line producer and was looking at budgets, I just started to teach myself and build upon what I already knew about budgeting. And I eventually was making budgets, you know, for hire. Like if you know how to edit commercials, like I really feel like any experience benefits filmmakers. Like you will pull something from any experience. At the very least, if you're going to reach out blindly and introduce yourself and say, I have a script about XYZ, here's the log line. Are you interested? Right? Because that way you're not just sending your script out into the ether.